As you know, I am a first-term member, and I entered my first budget optimistic about our potential to pass a budget that prioritized the needs of our communities. I have a lot of young people in my district. I've toured their classrooms. I've talked with their teachers about the challenges they face in those classrooms. Lots of schools in my community are chronically underfunded, with burgeoning classroom sizes and crumbling infrastructure. I've answered their questions about local government, explaining that yes, our state legislature can take action to solve the issue of their toxic schools. I've even corresponded with one young person about making the cheesesteak the official food of Pennsylvania. And, Mr. Speaker, I have attended their vigils. You see, Mr. Speaker, in my city, in my district, you cannot separate fully funding our schools and preventing violence amongst our at-risk youth. When we don't fully fund our schools, our young people die. How can we say we want to keep our community safe when we don't even provide our schools enough money to remove lead from drinking water? How can we say we want to keep our community safe when a child believes their opportunities on the streets are greater than their opportunities in the classroom? How can we say we want to keep our community safe when our public institutions are not safeguarded by us, duly elected public officials for our districts? Mr. Speaker, I agree that history will look upon our actions in this moment. And history will ask us, when we had the opportunity to provide transformational funding for our schools, funding that would have made sure that every child had a classroom that truly supported them, had an environment that made them feel loved and invested in, what did we do? Did we use that $7 billion rescue plan to rescue our youth? Or did we tuck it away, saving it for some hypothetical rainy day when we are in the middle of a thunderstorm? I cannot in good conscience vote for this budget. While I recognize the $300 million in new funding, I cannot be part of an action that throws away a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and my heart is heavy when I think about all of the children, all of the potential leaders and heroes who will be robbed of the future they deserve. As we head into the summer, I worry about our at-risk young people whose communities will stay divested from, whose schools will still be neglected, and who may not make it through the year because we gave them no chance for survival. I will be a no on this budget. The work continues. Thank you.